Welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Ayush Jain. Today I am giving you the demo of optical transducer strainer. The order code of this equipment is 52004. Now let me take you to the experiments. In this there are a total of 6 experiments. Now the first experiment is, object is characteristics of filament lamp. We have to study that. Now this is the circuit and these are the connections that we have to make. So first let me make the connections for you. Connect this A point of wire wound pot to ground. C point to plus 12 volt. B point to the input of power amplifier. And we have to connect this 0 volt to this minus of this voltmeter. Now connect the external ammeter from the output of power amplifier to this input and connect the output of this to the voltmeter positive. Now these are the connections that we have made. Now as we switch on our main supply and select ammeter in this, now this is our wire wound pot. This is experiment is to study the characteristics of filament lamp. As we increase the pot resistance, you can see the lamp will glow. These are the voltage readings. You can take the respective voltage readings and the current readings, voltage from here and current reading from the external ammeter. This will give you different readings of voltage and current at different levels. And you can also calculate the resistance of the filament lamp. Only this part we have to do in the first experiment. Now we move on to the second experiment. Our second experiment is characteristics of photovoltaic cell. This is the circuit and these are the connections that we have to do. Now first let me do the connections. Now the connections of second experiment. Connect this A to 0 volt of wire wound pot, C to plus 12 volt, B to input of power amplifier. Some of the connections are same as experiment 1, but still we are showing you output of power amplifier to this input. And output of this to the positive of voltmeter. Connect the negative to the 0 volt. Now we'll connect an external ammeter with the photovoltaic cell. Positive to the input and negative to the 0 volt.
This B which we have directly connected to the input of power amplifier, we also have to connect it to the output of photo transistor. Now these are the connections that I have done. Now as we switch on our main supply, you can see there is a voltage reading is 0. Now as we increase the resistance of our wire wound pot, the filament lamp will glow and you can take the readings of current in this. In this the current will come in microamperes and you can take the voltage reading with one step increasing in every reading, and at different voltage you can calculate different current. And you can plot the graph which shows like this. It's an increasing graph. That's it. And now that's it for the second experiment. Now the third experiment. It is the characteristics of photoconductive cell. This is the circuit diagram. These are the connections that we have to make. Now the connections for experiment number 3. Similarly connect A to 0 volt, C to plus 12 volt, B to the output of photo transistor, and through this connected to the input of power amplifier. The output of power amplifier will go in this input and this point is connected to the positive of voltmeter. Now in this we have to add an external, add one more pot, carbon pot of 10 kilo ohm. Connect C of this to plus 5 volt. B point to the photoconductive cell input. And we will take an external voltmeter. This time we will take a voltmeter, set it to voltage and connect it to the photoconductive cell. To the output of photoconductive cell and negative to the ground. Now these are the connections that we have made. Before switching on the system, we have to make an adjustment that we have to set the 10K carbon pot to 3 kilo ohm. So first of all, we take one more DMM, set it to resistance and set the value of carbon pot to 3K. As you can see in this, we have approximately set the value of this carbon pot to 3K. Now I remove the DMM. Now as we switch on our main, as we switch on our mains, you can take the voltage readings. As I increase the wire wound pot, the voltage will start reducing. As you can see, initially it was around 4.5 volt, and as I increase my wire wound pot, the voltage will start decreasing. So this shows the output of the third experiment, from which proves our graph, which is a declining graph as our voltage was decreasing. That's it in the third experiment. Now we will move to the fourth experiment, which is objective characteristics of pin photodiode. Now we move on to fourth experiment, which is characteristics of pin photodiode. This is the circuit diagram, and these are the connections that we have to do. Now I do the connections. Connect this A to 0 volt. Connect C to plus 12 volt. Connect B to the power amplifier input. The output of power amplifier is connected to the input, this point. The output of this block is connected to the positive of voltmeter. We have to connect pin photodiode input to the input of current amplifier. In this we have to perform with two blocks, first with the current amplifier block and then with the buffer block. The first time doing with the current amplifier block, the output of this is connected to the DC amplifier block. Before connecting it to the DC amplifier block, first switch on the mains and make the DC offset 0, DC offset input reading to be 0. Connect the positive to the input of DC offset and negative to ground. As we switch on, we see that there is a voltage of around 0.5. First of all, we make it to ground. Now this, we have made this voltage at 0. Now we'll connect the DC amplifier block. The output of current amplifier will go into DC amplifier input. And now we'll connect an external voltmeter to the output of DC amplifier and the negative to the ground. Now as we switch on our system, and now we'll take the different readings as we increase the value of wire wound pot. As we increase the value of the wire wound pot, the potential will, voltage will increase at the above, in the above direction. As you can show in this graph, the voltage is increasing. From 0 it will go approx to 6 volt. Now we'll perform the same experiment with the buffer amplifier block. Instead of current amplifier, just connect the buffer amplifier. The output which is output of current amplifier which is connected to the DC amplifier block, connected to the buffer amplifier output, at the input which is coming from pin photodiode to current amplifier, connected to the input of buffer amplifier. Before starting the test, first of all take an external voltmeter and make the DC amplifier again set it to 0. Our DC amplifier is approximately zero. The B point of this wire wound pot is to be first connected to the output of photo transistor and then to the input of power amplifier. Now, as we switch on our system after doing the complete connections, we will see as we increase the wire wound pot, the voltage will increase with the increasing pace, which will be approximately to 11 volt, as you can see in the DMM. It will be like this graph, from 0 to approximately 10 to 11 volt. That's it in the fourth experiment. Now we move on to the fifth experiment, which is characteristics of photo transistor. This is the circuit diagram of this, and these are the connections that we have to make. Now first let me make the connections. Now the connections of the fifth experiment. First connect this A point to 0 volt, C point to plus 12 volt, B directly to the input of power amplifier. The output of power amplifier is connected to this input. And this point is connected to the plus positive of voltmeter. We'll connect a photo transistor output to the B point of this carbon pot, 10K. And the C point of this is connected to the plus 5 volt. Now we'll connect an external voltmeter with the photo transistor and the negative to the ground. We'll set the carbon pot value minimum approximately around which gives approximately 1 kilowatt. That is minimum only. Now as we switch on our main supply, we'll see a voltage around 5 volt in our voltmeter reading, maximum 5 volt. As we increase the wire wound pot, you will see the voltage will decrease suddenly, with a sudden down, as you can see in the DMM. As I am increasing my car wire wound pot, the voltage is becoming zero. This shows this experiment. You can see this graph. Initially it is approximately 5 volt, and as the wire wound pot resistance is increasing, it gives a sudden downfall to approximately zero. That's it in the fifth experiment. Now we move to the sixth experiment, which is optically controlled switching system. This is the circuit diagram, and these are the connections that I have to make. In this optically controlled switching system, this mechanism shows that when the filament is on when there is complete light, the electronic switching LED will not glow, and as the light of the filament will diminish, the LED will glow. Now first let me make the connections for you. Now these are the connections for experiment 6. First of all, same connect A point to 0 volt, C to plus 12 volt, B point to the input of power amplifier, output of power amplifier to this input, this point to the plus volt, plus of the voltmeter. We'll connect a photoconductive cell, output of photoconductive cell, to the 100K carbon pot, B point. Its C point will be connected to plus 5 volt. And the A point will be connected to the 0 volt. The input of photoconductive cell will be connected to the comparator, A point. The B point of comparator is connected to the B point of carbon pot of 10K. C point of carbon pot 10K is connected to plus 5 volt. A point is connected to 0 volt. The output of comparator is connected to the input of electronic switch. The output of electronic switch is connected to the relay. Zero volt is connected to the COM. And NO is connected to the LED. Now these are the connections that we have made. Now we have to make some settings for this. As we switch on our mains, you can see that there is no light and the LED is glowing. We have to set the reading of carbon pot resistance such that the LED glows according to the filament lamp. Now when the filament lamp is glowing, the LED will be off, and as we decrease the light of the LED of the filament lamp, the LED will glow. That's it in the sixth experiment that we have to show. These are the six experiments of optical transducer trainer. For further information, please consult the lab manual. Thank you.